Class number 8. All right, so we're down to 8. Let's start here. Look at this one. Look at my arms. I want you guys getting used to your arms as hooks. Here to here. Let's start with this one here. It's a nice little shoulder hinge. Here to here. Let's do that 10 times. Thinking of your arms as hooks. Yes, you can punch and kick and do all these and right, but you also can use your arms as clinching hooks. All right, 6-5. So class number 8. Moving pretty fast. I do want to have a midterm next week, which is just all the stuff you hear me say over and over again. It should be fairly easy. It's true and false. Multiple choice. You always have a fighting chance. And like I said, I grade on effort. So as long as you're here on attendance, you're participating, especially those with a screen on. Let's go ahead and try this one here. Here to here. Here to here. Outside. Outside. And you're doing the discussions. You'll do fine, so don't stress over those things. But you do have the videos, you have the modules, you can always go back. You can always take notes, which I always encourage. Oh, what's up, TV? I'm trying to mirror this thing. TV just turned off. All right, good, good, good. Let's try this one here. Remember, arms as hooks. Here. Let's try this. You're going to see it when Jenny gets here. So the one that's over. One's under, one's over. Yeah. So kind of keep this up here. The one that's over, bring this hand to the chest. And then this one scoops and ends up as the under. At the same time, the one that's under is going to kind of scoop over. So this is under, this one scoops to over. All right, and then we do it again. All right, you know what? Let me show it to you. When she gets here, don't worry about that. All right, anyways, let's go here. Arm swings, a little bit of shoulder swings, and bring a little hips into it. Little hips. Come on, TV, why you just went off on me? My Vizio just died. Isn't that crazy? Vizio is a terrible brand. Never again. Always go Samsung. Team Samsung. Ugh, just turns off. I've always had issues with it. All right, and backwards. There you go. Came back. And good. All right, nice. And let's do a little bit of calf raise. Let's start simple. Start easy today. I'm trying to pull back a little bit today. All right, little calf and a little ham triceps. Let's do this over the head 20 times. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15. I gotta find the right angle where I'm not cutting my head off. Then I'm too far away. Keep going. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. And let's do that little twisty from low to high. Look, I'm bending my knees though. I'm coming across my body. Low to high. Low to high. Grabbing squats. Coming across my body here to here. 45 degree angle. But let's go. 9, 8. It's almost like a little golf swing motion. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And let's go the other side. Here to here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, and 1. Nice. And let's wake up the posterior chain, the glutes, hamstring, lower back. Back straight here. Let's go touch our toes, touch the sky, and then the second time we go between our legs. Touch the sky. Touch the toes, touch the sky, and between your legs, touch the sky. So you get a little stretch. Dynamic stretch. 12 times while I'm talking. All right, so just imagine, this is already the second week of class, and just think about how much you've learned already. And I always tell people, don't get frustrated. Some people get frustrated, especially if I'm throwing a lot of new material, a lot of information. Just kind of, what I do is I always compare myself to myself. Think about how much more you know this week, today, than you did 2 weeks ago. All right, think about if you were being attacked by yourself. I know it's weird. A thought experiment, but you're getting attacked by yourself 2 weeks ago, right? All right, and how you would have reacted before. Maybe you would have spazzed, maybe you would have, who knows? But now you know what to move. You know to move a little bit. You know how to move your head. You know what to do, what worst case scenario. You know to, little stuff like that. And each week, you're going to get progressively more and more experienced. All right, good. And nice. All right, let's try this one here. Let's squat down, and let's do a 1-2 punch right in the air. 10 times. Squat, 1-2 punch in the air. Squat, 1-2 punch in the air. Keep going, 10 times. And my fat leg still hurts. I can't believe it. I'm telling you, man, the power of kicks. It's an amazing tool. You guys have baseball bats attached to your legs, man. You guys learn how to kick, and you guys are comfortable and you're confident doing that. It's a powerful weapon. It's a powerful tool. It's a powerful deterrent. Kicking somebody in the leg, and they're just moving. That could be a great self-defense move. Push kick and move. Kick to the leg and move. Jab to the face and move. Just those three little things can do a lot. All right, nice. And let's go back to our little 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. Let's practice our four uppercuts, and let's practice our pivot. Four uppercuts and pivot back. Four uppercuts and pivot. And then let's try four uppercuts, step pivot. All right, so just practice your footwork. Stay nice and balanced. At the same time, you just throw little uppercuts, pivot. Uppercuts, pivot. Uppercuts, step pivot. Uppercuts. Also, remember the back one. I didn't really talk about when you pivot with the back leg, you kind of, on the back leg, you just kind of lean backwards and then pivot forward. You can also pivot backwards, is what I'm saying. You can pivot with the light, the back leg nice and light, or you can pivot with the front leg nice and light. It's a little harder, but let's go with it. Go with it. Go with it. Let's go. We're straight. We're just warming up. Four uppercuts, pivot. Four uppercuts, pivot. Four uppercuts, pivot. Four uppercuts, step pivot. Four uppercuts, pivot. Nice and loose. Good, good, good. Just warming up. All right, keep going, keep going, keep going. All right, so keep that in mind. All right, so today when Jenny gets here, we're going to learn a lot of new stuff, real self-defense. And I really need a partner. All right, striking's awesome. I keep saying it's great. I teach striking first because striking, a lot of it is footwork. And I really want you guys being mobile, moving, not standing still, not being stuck in the mud, not being a punching bag. Right? I hate when people, they just stand there with their hands down and they get punched in the face. Why? Of course, they're being attacked, which is horrible. But also, they're doing everything wrong. Their hands aren't up. They're not in their stance. They're not being mobile. And good. Nice. All right, let's try this one here. Feet here. Look at my hips. Imagine you have a hula hoop. You guys all had hula hoops as kids, right? You know what a hula hoop is, right? We're going to practice a little hula hoop motion. All right, so and on campus, I actually have a bunch of hula hoops. And we'd be doing hula hoops in class as a warm-up because there's actually a martial art kind of movement that goes with this. All right, so let's go 10 clockwise. 9, 8, 7, 6. Get your hips really good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the other direction. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, and let's go do it again. Let's do 2 to the right, 2 to the left. 2 to the right, 2 to the left. A little hula hoop dance. Keep going. Nice and loose. Really, I want you to emphasize, look at your hips. You're going forward and back. You're really emphasizing that. Why? Because we're going to learn to do what happens if somebody grabs you from behind. They bear hug you and they're trying to drag you into a van. Or they're trying to hold you while you get punched. You need to get out of that bear hug position. And you're going to use this little hula hoop motion. And I'll wait till Jenny gets here to show that. All right, nice. All right, good, good, good. And let's do a little leg strengthening. Nothing crazy. Let's just do this one here. Now, right, we're going to learn what happens when you guys are face to face, grappling, you're grabbing onto each other. Now things are going to change a little bit, right? So we're going to learn how to drop our level. How do we drop our level, right? When you drop your level, I want you to stay in your, always try to stay in your stance. Remember the stance, your stance is your home base. That's where you defend, that's where your offense. But also, even when you're grappling, sometimes your feet will go a little square, but in general, right, 1 foot forward, 1 foot back, that allows you to kind of be able, or you can put your feet square, that's fine either way. Anyways, let's start here, 1 foot forward, 1 foot back, and let's drop our level. Just like, so it's kind of like really just a split squat. Here, your hands are up, drop your level. And let's come up with punches, why not? So drop our level, 1-2. Let's do that 10 times. 1-2. 1-2. My back, look at my back is straight. That's what I want you to know. My back, I'm bending at the knees. My back stays straight. Oh, shoot, sorry.
Let me see if Jenny's. Somebody's texting me, but
hopefully that's not. All right, good. And let's go the other leg forward. This one, let's go cross hook. Squat down, cross hook. We're dropping our level. Dropping our level. And that's going to be key when we learn takedowns. Or what if somebody's trying to take you down? They're trying to take you off your feet. How do you prevent that? You got to learn to drop your level. Drop your hips. Your hips are key here. In general, the person whose hips are lower has the advantage. Has the advantage. That's why some people, oh, I'm so short. What if I get attacked by this big, tall person? Yes, it's a disadvantage for a lot of things, but it's also an advantage in certain other things. If you want to take them down, or if you want to attack the body, or if you want to hit the groin, or if you want to not get taken down. If your hips are lower than theirs, you will have the advantage. All right, nice, good. All right, we're still warming up. So let's practice our push kicks. I love push kicks. They're so simple. They're so effective. They work, but you have to be precise. All right, let's try this drill here. I'm in my stance. My front leg is nice and loose. Look at that. You see TIE fighters do that. Their front leg is, they're kind of bouncy with it. It's almost like they're dancing. They're kind of stomping. They do that because they make that front leg nice and loose. They're here. They're in their stance. And then they push kick. And then let's pivot. Push kick. Let's pivot in each direction. Push kick. Push kick. Push kick. All right, let's keep going. Let's get 8 of them. And remember that we push kick. We lean back and look at my hands. They always hover around the face. They hover around the face. Right? Push kick in each direction. Push kick. Because you don't know if they might try to punch you while you're push kicking. You might miss your push kick. They might defend it. You guys know how to defend it. They might swipe it. They might arm swipe it and then punch you in the face. So you gotta be ready for those. What ifs? All right, keep your hands. General policy, hands around the face. Your force field. These are your force fields. These are your armor. Hands around the face. Keep going. And let's try the back. Let's do the other leg forward. Let's try the same thing. Push kick. And then change direction. All right, so change your stance to the other leg. Push kick. Change direction. Push kick. Change direction. Let's get 8 push kicks. 6, 5, 4. 3, nice. Everybody working today. It's Thursday. Yeah, it's tough. 4 days in a row. It sucks. But we're going to get it done. We're going to show up. We show up, things happen. When you don't show up, that's when things go backwards. They stagnate. And good. Nice. All right. All right, good, good, good. And let's practice our prayer hand, right? Remember we learned that prayer hand. It's so simple. It's effective, right? What if somebody tries to grab you or choking you? And you'll see Jenny do it on me. I'm going to start choking Jenny. And she has to pop out. I'm a lot bigger than Jenny. Jenny's half my size. But she knows what to do. I'm going to start grabbing her. You guys know what to do, right? We make that little prayer hands. And the key here is this arm's not going to work. I'm bigger and stronger, right? Usually when they're attacking you, they're bigger and stronger than you. They're bullies. All right, so you gotta bend your, squat your legs, squat and explode up. And you go wrist to wrist, my inside wrist against their inside wrist. Don't go too far out, right? Our here's too hard, it's too strong here. Wrist to wrist, you pop wrist to wrist. Bend and pop. All right, so let's practice that. So we're standing here, minding our business. Some bully starts choking us. Where's my money? Or choky for whatever reason. We prayer hand escape, we bend our knees, we explode, we pop, we step back. If there's a wall behind us, we step to the side, and then we maybe punch and then get out. Let's try that 6 times. All right, we're standing here. All of a sudden, we start getting choked. Pair hand escape, pop, step, side step, maybe throw some punches, and move a little bit, a little circle a little bit. All right, good. Let's do that 6 times. So, and the key here is we learn everything slow motion, right? But in reality, you can't go, okay, pair hand, 1, squat down, 2, 3, explode. 4. No, we gotta do it all at once. We gotta do it all kind of simultaneously, explosively. All right, so maybe do it once or twice, slow-mo. And then, bop, bop, and then do it as fast as you can. Right, because the reality is, you're being attacked as fast as they can, and you better defend as fast as you can. All right, but do it properly though, don't do it sloppily. All right, ready? You're getting choked. Use your imagination. Prayer hand. Dip down. Bop. Bop, bop, bop. Or maybe jab a knee to the groin. Because they are kind of close to you. All right, yeah, so they choke you. You can start punching and eye poking and knee to the groin. You can do that, but in general, you want to get free. You want to get out of there. You want to get your distance. You want to be mobile. You want to be able to use your footwork, which is the best defense, right? All right, again, now full speed, three of them. All right, we're standing there. Prayer hand, pop, get up, pop up. Knee if you want, and you get out. Practice moving, though. I don't want to see you prayer hand and just stand there. No, that's step one. That's round one. They're going to attack you still. So always prayer hand, pop, pop, and get out. Nice. All right, good, good, good. Nice. Also, we're gonna learn how to, remember I said, when somebody takes your back like that, that's really bad. That's worst case scenario. You don't want anybody to take your back. Why? When they take your back, they can do whatever they want to you. They can throw you to the ground. They can drag you. They can hold you up. Other people punch you. They can choke you. They can punch you in the back of the head. That's worst case scenario. Don't want to let people take your back. That's why we learn how to move and pivot. But think about it the opposite way. If you're need to control somebody, you want to do that to them. So we're going to learn how to take their people's back. How do you take somebody's back? We're going to learn a little drill called the arm drag. Let me wait till Jenny gets here for that. But we're going to learn that today. So that's awesome. And yeah, let me wait on that. All right, anyways, right now let's finish up our little warm up. Yeah, let's get on the ground. Sorry, guys. Like I keep saying, part of this class is getting comfortable on the ground. And we're doing exercises that are strengthening our core, our legs, our hips, our upper body. Yeah, jiu-jitsu is getting comfortable on the ground. That's part of it. All right, I'm trying to tilt these cameras. Okay, let's do some push-ups, sorry. Push-ups get us stronger, doing them every day, right? We're not sore, we're just getting stronger. We're doing stuff repetitively. Let's do them a little differently today. Let's do regular 10 first, 10 push-ups, normal, on our knees, just as a warm-up. 10 push-ups, let's go. Regular 10 push-ups, nothing fancy, just up and down, let's go, 10, easy. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Good. Nice and nice, easy little warm up. Now let's try a little more advanced one, of course. You know me, always trying to push the limits a little bit. All right, let's do a push-up. Let's turn sideways. And let's bring our elbow to our knee, almost like we're elbowing our knee. Look at that, bam. And then we're coming back down. Push-up, elbow to knee. You can do them on your knees or you can do regular push-ups. Do it like this here. You turn sideways, you stay nice and controlled, elbow to knee. Push-up, elbow to knee. Or do them on your knees, that's fine. Either way is good. Let's get 12 of these. Push-up, turn sideways, elbow to knee. Push-up, turn sideways, elbows to knee. All right, so we're getting stronger in all these weird positions. Nice and controlled, no rush. No rush. Take your time, stay nice and controlled. Nice, that's the key in these. Learning how to be comfortable in these uncomfortable positions, situations. It's part of this class. Whoever's late, make sure you stay after. Just so you guys know, every time you come in late or early, I get a little beep. So I always know when you leave early. Sometimes I miss it though. It says, so-and-so has left early for some mysterious reason. I always know I'm hoping some good reason. All right, good. And let's do a little explosive one, sorry. That's good. And good. Let's do one more variation. This time, let's do our little clap push-ups. So we're on our knees, we're gonna push off the ground. Clap once, or you can clap twice. Some of you are real pushy. about one, twice, three times. Only 10 of them. These are really good at just learning how to push off, how to blast off. All right, so 10 plyometric push-ups. So we're here, we're pushing, regular push-up, but now we're clapping. 10, 9, let's go. Only 10 of them, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice, all right, good, good, good. That's good enough for upper body strengthening today. Let's do a little bit of core, of course, sorry. Let's flatten our back, flip it over. How are we feeling, are we good? Yeah, we're, once Chad's here, I'm gonna be talking a lot more, so today will be a lot chiller. So we're gonna keep going for a little bit longer. All right, let me make sure my camera's here. All right, on our back, just a little bit of core. All right, on our back here. Let's do here. Let's do this easy today. Easy. What's easy? Let's start from the beginning. Let's start here. Remember these? We started with these. Hands, fingertips on your thigh. We're gonna go past the kneecap. Thigh, kneecap. Thigh, past the kneecap. 20. Let's go. 20 crunches. Easy. Little crip crunches. You're rising from the crypt. 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. All right, another crunch variation. Abdominals. Let's do some side crunches. Why not? Turn sideways on your side hip. Right, we're turned on the side. My elbow is going to come towards my pocket. And actually, I'm going to tuck my leg in. Look at my leg. It comes in. So I'm kind of bringing my knee in, and my elbow is moving towards my pocket. I'm crunching, moving a little side crunch. Let's go. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And of course, Mr. the other side. All right, guys, and usually what happens with this class, you guys are gonna start getting annoyed by me. I get annoyed by me, especially 4 days straight. I hate the sound of my own voice, but so. 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. All right, so hit the upper core, the side core. Let's do a little bit of lower core. And let's do a little simple. Look at my legs, I'm flat. I'm gonna bring my knees to my chest. A little ball. Actually, that's it. Just simple, easy. Just bring your knees towards your chest. Balling up. Bringing your legs towards your knees, towards your hips. Let's go. 19, 18, 17. Maybe extend your legs a little bit. 15, just so you get that little feeling. When you hit the ground, if you simply ball up, you bring your legs and hips closer to you. It's a huge advantage than just laying flat on the ground like a lot of people do. They lay flat, they start flopping around like a dead fish, a fish out of water. No, ball up, bring your legs and hips into the mix. That way you have your arms, but you also now have your powerful legs and hips. And of course, you're gonna learn what to do with them when we start learning all these different techniques. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. All right. And good, good, good. And let's do a little bit of hip exercise. Let's keep it simple. Are we there? You guys hear me? All right, let's do some hip bridges. Hip bridges, hip bridges, hip bridges. Can you guys hear me? Yes? Somebody thumb up? Okay, thumbs up. You guys hear me? No? You can't hear me? No? Could somebody hear me? Nobody hear me? Anybody hear me?
Ah, why did it mute? That's so ridiculous. Sorry, guys. It's muted out by itself. I hate these.
You can hear me now. Yes? Okay. Sorry about that. I don't know why the hell it muted by itself. That's crazy. That's the first time that's ever happened. Somewhere over here. All right, good. Sorry. Next one. Let's do a little hip bridges, right? We're learning how to use our hips, our powerful hips. These hips are everything. They're so powerful. They're so much stronger than our arms. We're going to drive our hips to the sky. So let's do 10, 4, easy ones. 9, 8, 7. I don't know how that happened. It's so weird. It just decided to mute itself. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Trust me, I'm going to be happier than you guys when Zoom is finally over. All right, let's cross one leg over the top, and let's do one at a time. Right, because now we're kind of getting a little, we're working our strength, so we got to increase the load, the resistance, the challenge. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Actually, let's go 15, sorry, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right, Jenny, thank you. And the other leg, same thing, 15 hip bridges. Single leg, up and down, easy. How you feeling, Jenny?
Good, good, thanks.
It's a little pool setup.
That's good. No, I'm a little sore. I was worked out yesterday and the day before.
Oh, wow, you gonna compete?
Yeah, this Saturday.
Oh, nice, awesome. Where at? I'm gonna go check it out.
It's actually all the way in Stockton.
Stockton?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It's
walking. I don't know what that, 7 hours.
Yeah.
I drove there before.
Yeah.
All right, last count, then 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. All right, last one. Jenny's here. When Jenny's here, I'm actually going to talk for a little bit. So let's start with, let's end with the hard one. Sorry. I know I'm trying to say it easy today. Just so you guys can take a little breather after that. All right, so let's flip it over. Let's try this. Let's try this little motion here. We're going to be up on hands and feet like we always do. We're going to just start simple, forward and back. Twice, 1, 2. Scissor twice, 1, 2. And some of you can just keep doing that over and over again. But other of you, I want you to try this. It's called a sit out. Look at this. My bottom leg, my left side, my other leg, kind of kicks through. And I sit on the hip. And then I come back to that position. I do the same thing to the other side. Hip. All right? So that's optional. But some of you, most of you, it's a lot of you could do that. So everybody's going to do one forward, one back twice. Two scissors twice. Some of you will keep going with that. Other you guys will try to kick in that little sit out. The little sit out. All right, we're done for 30 seconds, all right? Not a long time. All right, ready? And then we're gonna, you guys take a little breather while we go over some new moves with Jenny here. Ready, ready? And hit it, let's go. Let's go, forward twice, scissor twice, and add that little sit out for some of you. The rest of you can just keep going. Somebody left, which is fine. I'm sure they had something super important to do. Keep going, 22. I'm gonna count really slow, sorry. I want you guys to get a nice little 21, 20, nice. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10 more seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and time. All right, everybody, great job. Take a breather, grab some water, but
Jenny's here, so I gotta take advantage. There's a lot of things I wanna show you guys, but I can't do it by myself. So I'm gonna go through a bunch of new moves for us. So sit there, pay attention. If you wanna take notes, take notes. Well, you don't have to, because I'm recording all these. I record all these, so they're always there for you to go back and watch. All right. Let me find the proper camera angle. By this time, I should have everything perfected, which I don't. All right, good, good, good. Nice. All right, so let's go through some more scenarios. So now, right, you hear me say a thousand times, scenario one, talk your way out of it, defuse, de-escalate, get the hell out of there. So that's not working. You got to go into defense mode. The best defense is delaying, moving around, being mobile, not standing there with your hands down, boom. Right, that doesn't work, go into damage mode, right? Just hit them or push kick, try to keep them away from you, boom. Some of you who feel really comfortable striking, that's another option. A lot of times, that's not a great option, right? Sometimes it's a drunk uncle. Sometimes it's a mentally unstable person. Sometimes we don't have all these legal ramifications. So sometimes we wanna stop them. Or maybe we are striking with them and we get hurt. Or we get tired, so many different scenarios in self-defense. You get hurt, right? You're striking with somebody, oh, they clipped you, boom. You get rocked, what do you do then? What do you do when you get tired? What do you do? There's so many what ifs. All right, so we gotta have other options. We have to have plan B, plan C, plan D. All right, so the next option is, this physio's killing me. It just turns off for no reason. It pisses me out. I'm so done with physio. All right, anyways, still, you guys are still there though. All right, so anyways, what I'm saying is, what are some other options? So option one, I'm being attacked. Let me do it to Jenny, she's gonna do it to me next. So Jenny's here. Maybe I'm trying to get out of it. I go for a groin strike, it's not working. Maybe we're fighting, maybe she cracks me, maybe I get tired, whatever. So key is, I should be trying to run away. If I can't run away, or any of these other scenarios, I gotta do the opposite of run away. So in general, right, keep your distance, try to stay safe. If that doesn't work for whatever reason, we gotta do the opposite. The thing is, when I'm here, remember, the danger zone. I can hit her, she can hit me, I'm in danger. Out of the danger zone, when I'm moving, I'm safe. I'm also safer, not safe, but safer, if I do the opposite. And how do I do the opposite? I can't just walk in and close the distance. I have to do it properly. So what we do, right? We're being attacked, maybe Jenny's slapping me, punching me, I'm defending, I have my helmet on. I have to put my helmet on, and I have to crash into her. I call it moving into the fire. You have to go into the fire, I have to crash into her. Right when I crash into her, I need to lock her up. I need to take her arms away. So that's what we do. We learn these little hooks. Look at that. This over, this under, or I have one arm under the armpit and one over the top. So this is called a clinch. It's not a hug, right? Hey, Jenny, I miss you. This is a clinch. This means I'm tying up her arms. I'm using my arms as hooks. This one clamps, right? I grab her lat or her shoulder and I keep it clamped. My chest and my shoulder are tight, tight here. My other arm grabs her tricep or elbow and I clamp down. This is clap. And in class, on campus, I'd make you guys get in this position here. And I'd say, one of you guys hold that person, the other person try to slap them. And here's the other key here. Your head needs to be on the overside. Whatever hand is over the top, over hook side, your head needs to be there. I like to put my head right in their ear or their chin. So I'm clamping down here, I'm clamping here. And I say, hey, try slap me, Jenny. Right, so I'm clamping now, I'm holding here. And I'm nice and balanced, right? I'm not too tall. I'm bending my legs, my back is straight, and I'm nice and balanced here. Yes, you can always fight from here, you can do knees to the groin or striking, but in general, what I'm trying to do here is I'm saying, hey, stop hitting me. Time out. This is a partial timeout. So here, we're fighting. So remember, I need to clear my head, I need to think, what am I gonna do next? I want this person to stop hitting me. I need to slow them down. So I clinch them up, but I have to do it properly. If I don't have my head on the proper side, look at that. Have my hand on the over under hooks, like she could punch me in the face. Boom. She can scratch me in the eye or poke me in the eye. So I have to keep it everything properly. Head on the overhook side. I'm pinching. I'm clamping. I'm pushing here nice and tight. So this is called the over under clinch. C-L-I-N-C, edge, clinch. So from the beginning here, we're here. You're punching here. I put my helmet on. I crash into immediately. One goes under. One goes over. It doesn't even matter. As a matter of fact, one of the drills you're gonna do is you're gonna learn how to get really comfortable going over, under, how to crossing over, back and forth. This is called a pummel drill. We're pummeling back and forth. All right, so this is actually a class. You guys need to be really comfortable in using your arms as hooks. So actually, let's start with the pummel drill.
That's why in class, I would use this as a warm-up. We do it a lot. So the pommel drill, we start in the over-under position here. And the hand that's over, this hand goes from the tricep to the chest. And at the same time, she's gonna do the same thing on the other side. So my hand that's over, it goes to my chest, and then I dig under, it goes to the under. And then I bring my head to the over side, here to here. And I do the same thing. This hand that's over, goes to my chest, and I dig under, it's like I'm scooping. It's like we're swimming. Look at that, we're swimming. Our hands are going back and forth. Boom, boom. We start slow, and then we speed it up. Bam, bam, hey, seven. So right now, our feet are not moving. We're just doing the upper body. After a while, we want to get a little more advanced. Then we can kind of move around a little, make it a little more, look at that, make it a little more realistic. Ah, we're moving around, we're scooping, over, under, clinching, fighting here. And in class, I would have you guys doing this over and over again. So you get really comfortable using your arms as hooks. Later on, I'll say, hey, let's fight from there. Sometimes I'll say, well, anyways, I don't want to confuse you. So that's called the pommel drill. Pommel drill. And the whole purpose of that is using your arms as hooks so we can tie them up, so we can stop them. And I'm telling you, even Canelo, if Canelo got rocked, I keep using Canelo because he's the best boxer right now. He's the best boxer in the world. Even him, if he got rocked, if he got hit, if he got tired, he would clinch up. He would hold you. He would say, hey, stop punching me for a little bit. Let me catch my breath. Let me decide what to do next. Let me clear the cobwebs. And then he would separate and then they keep fighting or whatever the situation is. Okay, does that make sense? Yes? All right, so that's the pommel drill. And the reason for that is the over-under clinch. We want to stop them. We need a partial timeout. We need to catch our breath. Good. All right, nice. Eventually, in class, we'll also learn how to, there's five different clinches. And I teach you guys five different clinches, not to confuse you, because some of them are real defensive. Over-under clinch is very defensive. It's just, hey, stop hitting me. Yes, there's stuff you can do from there, and we're going to learn what to do. From there, right, we can't stay there forever. Eventually, you can open up and start fighting again, or you can go for a takedown. You can try to grab their leg. You can try to take their back. You can try to scoop under. You can do a bunch of stuff, and one thing at a time, so just keep that in mind. The other clinches, I want to show them right now. That's too much. The other type of clinches are more offensively. You can fight from one. Let me just show you one. So this is over-under clinch. This is safe. If I want to, grab the top of the head, one, bam. I can do it to another type, right? We already know this one. You're grabbing the top of the head, now you can start kneeing them. This is called a plum clinch. This is another type of clinch. This is more offensive, though. This is just to do damage. Grab their head. Okay? Got that? All right, good. Next thing I want you guys to learn is, what if somebody grabs you from behind, right? I grab Jenny from behind. Hey, Jen, I'm trying to kidnap or whatever they're trying to hold here. Jenny knows what to do. So immediately what she does, she drops her weight. Why does she do that? Because she gets heavier. Now it's harder to move her. Now she's nice and balanced. Also, if she doesn't drop her weight, I can knock her over. I can tip. I can throw her to the ground. She drops her weight. She starts fighting the hands, right? Look at her. She starts digging the hands. She's like pushing down. Now what she's going to do is she's going to do that little hula hoop motion. She's going to use her hips like a little hula hoop and pop out and push out and just pop, pop, pop. All right? So the key here is don't go, or don't stand tall. So steps. So somebody grabs you from behind, right? You're just standing there. They grab you from behind. Immediately we drop our weight, right? That makes us nice and balanced, almost like we're squatting. We peel the top hand. We kind of stick our fingers in there. We kind of peel in there. And then don't just go, so we arm to arms. That's not going to work. You kind of use that little hula hoop motion. And you use your hip, the power of your hips. The power of your hips. And you push down. And sometimes it doesn't work. Sometimes you got to keep popping. You got to keep popping, pushing. Immediately, once it's open, you got to get out and get into the step. Bam. Okay, so that's called the bear hug escape. The bear hug escape, right? Remember, you never want anybody to take your back. It's really bad, right? So somehow, some way, they sneak up and get you. All right, Jenny's smart. She's not going to let me. She's here. She's going to peel the hands. She's going to pop, pop, pop. And pop, bam. Good. So she's going to explode out. Oh, the other thing, this is Jenny. I didn't even introduce Jenny.
Hi, guys.
So Jenny is, she's a purple belt. She's about to get her brown belt. She's a high level, she's a martial artist. And she's a striker now. She's learning everything. I think she wants to fight later. So she's a true example of, she wants to be a teacher. She's a mother. She's got two kids. And she's a martial artist. So she's learning all this stuff here. And I'm telling you, I've seen her smash guys my size. She takes their soul. She submits them. I'm telling you guys, so everybody can learn. So it's awesome. Hopefully later on when we do jiu-jitsu, you'll see her doing a lot of these other moves. Okay, so we got that. Bear, it's pretty. These things are simple-ish, but you got to do the steps properly. If you stand tall, you're gonna get thrown down. If you're just going arm to arm, you're not gonna get out. You got to do everything all kind of at the same time. Drop your hips, peel the hands, pop with your hips, open the hands, and get out. You never want to let anybody take your back. Okay, it's bad. But the flip side of that, if in a bad situation and you don't want to strike with them, or maybe you struck with them and you want to take their back. How do we take somebody's back? Right? You saw Jenny was doing. She's not going to let you. Smart people don't let you take their back. They're pivoting. They'll never let you take their back. So you got to earn it. You got to fight for it. How do you get to somebody's back? So number one, we got to get closer here. And this is a key technique here. I love this technique. It works on the feet. It works on the ground. It works everywhere. It's called the arm drag. Actually, let's learn this little drill first. And in campus, and part of the discussion, I'll have you guys do this. Hopefully you can find a partner. You're going to stand square. All right, you're gonna stand square across from each other. And one person, I should do it to me first. So Jenny's gonna grab here. She's gonna grab anywhere. She could grab my choke me or shoulder. All right, so here's the drill. It's called the arm drag drill. She is here. So what I'm gonna do is do that little wax off. Remember the Karate Kid? Wax off. And it's not just like I'm using my legs, my hips. Wrist to wrist, wax off. I peel a hand off, I break it off, and then immediately I grab the watch. Grab the watch. From here, I swing it open, but at the same time, look at it, my other hand grabs the elbow. So I have two arms on one, two of my arms on one. And then I open the door. I swing the door open. Why am I doing that? Because if I don't do that, we're gonna fight here. It's gonna be a dog fight. I want to open the door because I want to get to her back. Now I can step with the inside leg or I can step with the outside leg, depending on what I want to do. Right now we're gonna step with the outside leg. So she grabs here, I arm, so step one. We do the wax off, wrist to wrist. I use my wrist. Bam, I grabbed here, two on one, on the tricep or the elbow. I swing the door open. At the same time, I step to the outside. Look what I did, I opened the door. I have a pathway to her back. From here, I don't care about the arm. I let go of the arm. All I care about is I want to take her back. So from here, I could do the bear hug, or I can punch, or I could take her down, or I can jump on her back and go for a choke. We're gonna learn all that. We're gonna learn all those moves. Okay, but the key here is we gotta get good at this arm drag. So first we're gonna do a slow-mo. She's gonna grab here, bam, here, and bam. And then we're gonna do a little faster. A little faster. Swam. All right, in class we'll be doing it over and over again until it becomes, so I don't even think about it anymore. I just go, swah. And then I close my eyes. I do it with my eyes closed. Then I tell her to do it either side. I do it the other side. So I do it with my eyes closed. So at first we get good at one side. All right, so I do it to Jenny. She goes, bam. But yeah, so she just, and after a while it becomes nice. And it could work there, it could work if I'm trying to choke her. It doesn't matter. Or even I'm not trying to grab her. My hands are here, she could still do it. She could just arm drag all day. So remember, the arm drag is your portal, your doorway to get to the side of them. And here, it's a fair fight, right? It's 50-50. I can hit them, they could do me, or they can kick me. But if I get to the side, I could have a lot more advantages. Or to the back, even better. So that's called the arm drag drill. So for you guys, I'm hoping you find a partner and start simple here. Just do one side at a time and go slow at first, right? Wax off, grab the elbow, open the door, step to the outside. And I want you to step with the outside leg first because we're gonna do a little move later. Actually, let me show you the move first. So here, one, this is the move you're gonna learn. Elbow, arm drag, I open the door, I step with the outside leg, I let go of the arm. From here, my arm, look at my arm. I do like a little clothesline around Jenny's neck. Boom, I come around the rack. I'll let her do it to me so you can see it. So I got around, look at it, I run the back here. I'm choking here and we'll learn how to finish later. I go palm to palm or I can do the full choke. I stick my hips in and you can choke them out from there. And that's a move I want you guys to learn. You can move, you can learn it. It seems complicated, it's really not. It's really just doing the arm drag, biting on the neck. Actually, you can do it. And here's the other issue. Like, I'm a lot taller than Jenny, so she's gonna, so maybe I'm here, I'm gonna try to grab Jenny. She's gonna arm drag me. Whoa. Immediately she goes back and she's kicking her hips in. She's gonna break my posture. She's gonna break my posture. If they're really tall, she's gonna jump on my back. She's being nice now. She can jump on my back and just stick her legs over my hips. And I'll show it tomorrow. I don't wanna overwhelm you guys. I just wanna introduce it today. Today, this is all new stuff. So this is, but the key here is you gotta earn your way to the side. Nobody, unless they're drunk or stupid. Hey, I'm gonna go and choke you, right there. Yeah, you can do whatever the hell you want to them. But for the most part, most people, they're not gonna let you do that. So that's called the arm drag. All right. So far we learned the prayer hand. All right. So the prayer hand. So somebody's choking. You know how to remember the prayer hand?
No.
So here she's choking me. Remember the prayer hand. Explode. Wrist to wrist. We pop out. Bam. Even from there, look at that. I can do an arm drag from there. I can do a prayer hand to arm drag. Let's do it again. So she's choking me. I prayer hand. Boom. Arm drag. I start choking. Or I can do a takedown. Or I can start punching. I can get dirty and punch him in the back of the head. These are all options. 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 Okay, so that's the prayer hand. And then the other one, we can do an arm drag. Arm drag to, I do a body lock. Look at that. And then she knows what to do. And in class, I have you guys doing this. Popping the hand, pow, pops out, and immediately spinning out. So these are all things we're learning. We're learning all these different scenarios. What if they grab you from behind? What if they choke you? What if they, or what if you want to do that to them? Okay, so all this little extra stuff. Okay, we got that? Any questions? All right, I'm giving you guys a bunch of different these little drills, and the reality is you're not going to get good at them unless you do them over and over and over again. And that's the hardest part of this. You have to find a partner. If you want to get good at self-defense, you have to do this stuff over and over. You got to be obsessive compulsive, I say. It's repetition, right? If somebody's trying to grab you, you go, okay, wax off. If you're doing a slow mo, it's not going to work. They're going to get out. They're going to punch you in the face. What are you doing? They're going to knee you. So you got to do this stuff over. So you got to find a partner. Teach them what you're doing. That's always good to help you remind it. Teach them what you're doing it step by step. Do super slow and then speed it up. And then challenge yourself. Right? Do one arm. Do the other side. Close your eyes. And then back and forth. And then later on we spar. Okay, good. We got that. All right. Let me give you one other drill so you can do it on your own. Also, this is called the paddy. So now we're doing kind of striking. Jenny's going to get her stance here. A good way for you, if you get a partner, you can also do what's called the patty kick drill. What is it? Is this a way for you to do mitts? So I'm going to use my hands as mitts. You guys play patty kick as kids? Jenny is going to go through her punches. So I'm going to tell her jab, boom, cross, boom. See what I did? Jab, cross. I'm just playing patty kick. And what I'm doing here is I'm doing the opposite side arm. Right? This is the same side. This is the opposite arm. Right? So hold it up. So this is the same side arm. But in general, when we play patty kick, you want to do opposite side. See that? It makes it a little cleaner. So Jenny's doing jab, cross. Let's go double jab, cross, jab cross, jab cross, jab cross. Nice. Good. You see that? So you can just practice this. Find a partner. I have really strong hands. If you're worried about your hands, you can wear socks over it, or they can wear socks over their hands, or you can buy gloves, which you should do anyways. I really encourage you to buy gloves. They're cheap, and this is awesome. You can do this all day. You can do, and look, I can even throw punches back at her. So she's gonna do jab cross. I'm gonna throw jab cross at her, and she's gonna slip, slip. Jab cross, slip, slip. Look at that. Let's do that three times. Jab cross, slip, slip. Jab cross, slip, slip. Jab cross, slip, slip. Jab cross, slip, slip. Nice. And on campus, you guys will be doing that all day. So this is called the patty cake drill. It's awesome. And you can do every punch with this. Look at this. So jab is a straight punch. Cross is a straight punch. If I want to do a hook, she's going to do a left hook. I'm going to turn my hand sideways. So I'm just giving her little targets. So right hook, left hook, right hook, left hook, right hook. Nice. How about jab cross hook? Let's try that one. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Nice. So you guys get the idea. This is called the patty kick drill. You can do this all day. It's fun. And you guys can take turns. One person does, the other person does. Keep it simple. Or it could be hardcore. She's going to do jab cross hook. And then I'm going to throw it back at her. She's going to slip, slip, under, right? We go under punches. Jab, cross, hook, slip, slip, under. Nice. So we do that three times, a little faster. Jab, cross, hook, slip, slip, under. Nice. Jab, cross, hook, slip, slip, under. Jab, cross, hook, slip, slip, under. Nice. So you can do that. Awesome. You can also do overhands. How about overhand? So overhand, I want to make my hand like a little plate. Look at that. So let's go jab, overhand. Boom. Nice. Jab, overhand. Jab, overhand. Let's go jab cross. Jab cross hook. Jab overhand. Beautiful. How about uppercuts? I just gave my little targets. Look at this in my hand. So this is a jab. This is a cross. This is a high. Let me get sideways. Sideways, overhand, and then uppercuts. I do it downward. So let's do one each one. Jab. Cross. Hook. hook, overhand, uppercut, back uppercut, 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 jab, cross, upper, upper. Beautiful. So you can go through all these punches. You can go slow-mo, you can go light, then later on you can throw punches back at them. All right, got that? So that's another drill you can do. So you guys have all these fun drills you can do over the weekend. Right? You don't have to do it for a whole hour, just do it for 5 minutes. Do it 5 minutes every day. You have arm drag drill, you have the pommel drill, you have the patty cake drill. What else drill do we have? We're gonna have a bunch of other ones. And get into these weird positions. On campus, I take this class seriously, so I have you in all these positions and I have you guys fighting out of each one. Okay, somebody's got your back. One person's gonna hold you, the other person has to get up. Get up! So I make you guys drill from there. Or I'll have you guys doing pommel drill and I says, hey, another great drill. All right, let's learn a second clinch. Remember, I'm gonna teach you guys five clinches. You just learned two. We have the over-under clinch and we learned the pommel clinch. You just grab the top of the head. Especially if I'm tall, Janet's gonna grab the top of my head. From here, she could light me up with knees. Boom, knees. Or she could move me around. Move me around, bam, and then throw the knees. Boom, and then push off, and then punch me. And she can do whatever she wants, right? So that's the second clinch. A third clinch, you guys hear me? Good? Okay, another type of clinch is right, it's very similar to the over-under clinch. We have one under hook, one over hook, and I'm safe here. I'm pretty safe here. But I can also try to get two under hooks, right? So one is already there. Now the other one, we already know how to do it, right? We do that pommel drill. We kind of open up a little bit, the hand goes to chest, and I scoop under. Now I have two under hooks. I can clamp here, I can hold here. Look at this is nice, this is a good position here because it's nice and tight here. She can punch me or slap me a little bit, but for the most part, from here I can do a lot. From here I can break the back, I can go for a takedown, or I can just hold her here. And in class, I would have you guys, I keep saying, on campus, I would have you guys doing fighting for double unders. So we started over unders, and we'll say, hey, let's go. Who can get double under hooks? And we'll be fighting here. We're booking, try to get it. We're just, look at that, we're trying to digging, right? Oh, Jenny got it right away. So we're fighting for it. We're not letting it happen. We're both going for double under hooks because it's an advantageous position. It's stronger. In general, when you got under hooks, it's stronger than over hooks. I might be a little stronger than Jenny, but if she gets under hooks, she has more leverage. She has her hips, and remember, the hips are the lower. The hips are the lower person. So fighting for double unders is another drill I'd have you guys do. I guess, all right, anyway, so this is a lot of stuff I'm throwing at you guys. We got it, though? All right, good enough, that's good enough. All right, so I just wanted to take you guys. So let's do 5-10 minutes, let's do a little combos, get you guys nice and sweaty for a little bit, and that's good enough for today. All right, so let's go through our little combos. Let's go through our little usual stuff that we do, our little cardio kickboxing, but with real self-defense moves. Okay? All right, everybody up, everybody up. Those of you with your screens off, I just like to put you here, make you feel. All right, anyways. All right, we're in our stance. We're always bouncing. Let's do a jab, cross. Step in with it, and then step up. Let's do that 5 times. Let's start, jab, cross, step up. And start slowish. And then pick it up, jab cross, step in, step out. Let's go, jab cross. So we're stepping in the danger zone, out of the danger zone. Bop, 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 bop. Two more, bop, bop, one more, bop, bop. Good, so that's nice and simple, that works, good. How about we set it up first? Let's do a back push kick, and then jab cross, bam, and step out. Back push kick, then jab cross. All right, so they're thinking push kick. Maybe they drop their hands, and then we punch them right in the nose. That's nice and effective, back push kick. Jab cross, good. Back push kick, jab cross. One more, back push kick, jab cross. Beautiful, nice. All right, now let's try one of our little fancy moves. Remember we learned that spear jab. We step in with a spear jab, and then we cross them to the groin. Let's try it out. It works, these are simple, these are realistic. They work. So remember the spear jab, we push off the back leg, we explode, they'll never expect it because we're covering so much distance. Bam, spear jab, cross to the groin or the stomach, it's fine either way. Spear jab, cross to the groin. So we hit him in the face, and go, oh, it leaves him groin wide open. Bam, bam, again. Spear jab, cross to the groin. Spear jab, cross to the groin. Nice, all right, good. How about this one? We wanna get in, we wanna elbow and knee them. We can't elbow and knee them from way out here, so we gotta come in. So let's throw jab cross, we got in close. And then from here, let's go side elbow, up elbow, up elbow, and then grab the top of their head, and then finish them off with two knees and push them off. Let's do that five times. All right, so we're back here. We're gonna come at them, jab, cross, even if the punches don't land, who cares? We're just getting in close. Now we're gonna get them some, slice them, elbow, up elbow, up elbow. Grab their head, clinch them up. Knee, knee, push them off. Good, that's two, three more. Jab, cross, elbow, elbow, up elbow, up elbow. Knee, knee, nice, push them off. Again, jab, cross, elbow, elbow, up elbow, up elbow. Knee, knee, good, two more. Jab, cross, elbow, elbow. Up elbow, knee, knee, push them off. Nice, good. All right, good, good, good. Now let's do a little bit of the other drills we've been doing. Remember, let's go here. Let's do that little drill. I like this one. We've been doing it over and over again, so we should be getting good at this. Let's go jab, cross, slip to the right. And then come right back with a cross, hook, slip to the left. And come back with a hook, cross, and then let's get under twice. And then let's go four uppercuts. And let's move backwards as we're blocking. One, two, three, four. All right, so it looks like a little dance, but really we're combining offense with defense, punches with head movement and footwork. We're doing all of that. We're doing all the right things. All right, ready? Let's go. Jab, cross, slip, cross, hook, slip, hook, cross, under, under, four fast uppercuts, block, 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 block. Beautiful. Let's keep, that's one. Let's do it four more times, each time a little faster. Jab, cross, slip, cross, hook, slip, hook, cross, under, under, four fast uppercuts, block, 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 block. Nice, really looking good. I like it. Jab, cross, hook, slip, hook, cross, under, under, four fast uppercuts, block, 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 block. Beautiful, two more. Jab, cross, hook, slip, hook, cross, under, under, four fast uppercuts, block, 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 block. Beautiful. One more. Jab, cross, hook, slip, under, under. Ah, I missed that. Four best uppercuts. Fly, 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 fly. It don't matter if you're moving your head, moving your feet. Beautiful. Nice. All right. Good, good, good. We also have a bunch of other weapons. Let's go this one. Let's go jab, cross, hook. And then let's go, let's go kick, knee, push kick with one leg. Look at that, all those options you have with one leg. I love it. So let's go jab, cross, hook, and then I throw a side kick. And then I bring it back, I could do a knee. I bring it back, I do a push kick. And let's go jab, cross, moving backwards. All right, got it? Let's go. Jab, cross, hook, kick, knee, push kick. Jab, cross, nice. Again, jab, cross, hook, kick, knee, push kick. Jab, cross, again, jab, cross, hook, kick, knee, push kick, jab, cross, one more, jab, cross, hook, kick, knee, push kick, jab, cross, last one, I said, jab, cross, hook, kick, knee, push kick, jab, cross, nice, looking good, all right, what time is it? All right, let's do a couple more, a few more. Let's do some more little fancy moves that I threw in yesterday. I like that little double knee. Let's practice that first. Remember the double knee. You're jumping in the air, your one knee is coming up in the air, but you're really trying to set up the second knee. That's the one that lands. Right? So knee. So I'm here. Let's do a jab cross first. Jump in the air with the knee, and then the other knee comes up. It's so like a 1-2 ba. Your back knee looks like it's gonna land, but the other one's the one that really lands. Ba-ba. Actually, let's go jab, cross, hook, cross, and then jump double knee. Five times. And let's step a little tiny bit while we're punching. Jab, cross, hook, cross, and then jump double knee. Bam. See that? I'm stepping a little bit with each punch. Just I'm closing the distance. Right? Because it's rare that they just stand there. They're probably going to be moving back a little bit. So you got to close the distance as you punch. Jab, cross, hook, cross, jump double knee. Right? They might dip their head, and that's when you hit them with a knee in the face. That's when you finish them off. Jab, cross, hook, cross, jump double knee. Nice, I like it. Jab, cross, jump double knee. I know a few of you are anime fans. You want to be an anime superhero, a classy hero from My Hero Academy. Okay, Jab cross, hook cross. Bam. One more. Jab cross, hook cross. Jump double knee. Nice, beautiful. All right, good, good, good. Let's do a couple more. Let's do a lot of reps. Just so we can finish off. And it is Thursday, which means you don't have to see my beat up ogre face for 3 days. All right, so let's do 10 straight punches. Let's do 10 hooks, 2 to the face, 2 to the body. Let's do 10 uppercuts. Let's do 10 elbows, 2 side, 2 up. Let's do 10 knees, 10 push kicks. And what else do we have? That's good enough. All right, so that's a lot of reps. And we're gonna do that 2 or 3 times, and then we're done. Okay, ready, ready, nice and stand, nice and loose. Remember, shifting your weight back and forth, we're on our toes, nice and loose, ready, ready, ready. And let's go, straight punches. Jab, cross, 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 and good. Let's go 2 hooks to the face, and then hook to the body. Remember, punching, protecting, though. I want things to be nice and clean. Hook to the face, hooks to the body. Face, body, face, body, face, body. Shift those hips, face, body, and good. Let's go 10 uppercuts, nice and fast, but use your hips. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Let's do elbows, side up, 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 side, side, 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 up, up. Let's go push kick, 10, 9, 8, lean back a little bit, 8, 7, hands up around your face, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, wow. Let's do walking knees. Let's grab the head. 10. Walk with each step. Now 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Wow. Nice. All right, let's do that whole thing one more time. Let's add a little defense in between each. So let's go in between each one of those. Let's go slip, slip, under, under, block, block. 3 times. All right, in between each one, transition. All right, ready, ready? 10 straight punches and then slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Ready, ready? And let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now give me 3 slip, slips, under, under, block, block. 3 times. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Good. Now let's go to hooks. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Go back to your defense. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. One more. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Let's go 10 uppercuts, but let's pivot a little bit while we're doing it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's go back to slip, slip. I'm going to show you my stance. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. 3 times. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block. And let's go to elbow. Side, side, up, up. Side, side, up, up. 10 times. 8, 7, 6. Turn those shoulders. 8, pull back. Make sure you pull back. That's where the power comes from. Pull back. Wah, bah, bah. Use your legs, use your hips. 4, 3, 2, and wow, my slimy sweat's starting to sweat. So I slide. And slip, slip, again. Repetitions. Get that head movement. Let's go. It's like a dance. Create self-defense dances. It's like the Taibo style. And what's left? Let's go push, kick, knee. Let's do that 10 times. Push, kick, knee. Push, kick, knee. Push, kick, knee. Push, kick, knee. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, good, good. Let's try this one. Let's go slip, slip, under, under, block, block, pull back, pull back. Add that little extra one. Remember, we pull back, pull back. Just get your head out of the way. Let's go. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block, pull, pull. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block, pull, pull. Last one. Slip, slip, under, under, block, block, pull, pull. And good. Last one, 10. Knees. Let's walk them down. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then real last, sorry. Let's do 50 uppercuts and a 20-second sprint, and we're done. That's it. sorry. I want you guys, I know you got a whole weekend to recover. All right, let's go. 50 uppercuts as fast as you can. And remember, arms are loosey-goosey. What it's doing is your shoulders, your hips. Oh, everything comes from here. Bah. All right, that's where the speed comes from. And then we're going to sprint. How do we do that? Right, L. We're going to sprint in place. Right, so that's the best self-defense. Get out of there. Get the hell out of there. Even if you won, you might want to get out of there anyways. Avoid the legal charge. Nah, I'm just kidding. All right, anyways, let's go. 50 uppercuts, 20-second sprint, and we're done. I'm going to do it from the southpaw stance, just to change it up. Ready, ready? And hit it, fast as you can. 50, 49, 48, 47, 46, 45, 44, 43, 42, 41, 40, 39, 38, 37, 36, 35, 34, 33, 32, 31, 30, 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 60, 50, 40, 30, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But there's Terminators, they're still coming at us. Let's get out of here. Let's get on our bikes. Let's go. Sprint, 20 seconds, 19, 18, as fast as you can. Let's go. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. Now, I'm going to spin around the pool. 5, 4, 3, 2, and boom. All right, everybody. Great job. Perfect. All right, so I threw a lot of little kind of new stuff at you. Learning what to do with this happens. That's what self-defense is. Start visualizing, start thinking, and start putting yourself in these situations. Find a partner. I know it's hard, but if you want to get good at self-defense, you have to drill. Drill. There's no way around it. Every grandmaster has done it over and over and over again. That's why you see these martial artists and they look like they're just flowing. They're not even thinking. They're really not thinking. They don't have to think. They don't know, wax off, pull off. They don't have time for that. They just react. They just do it because they've done it 1,000 times. It's programmed. It's there. It's in you. It's already in you guys. All right, awesome, everybody. Any questions on anything? All right, thank you, Matt. Yeah, and let's thank Jenny here. She got up early, all the way over here. I really feel bad. No. I always offer her gas money or anything, and she always never accepts anything. But I got to get her something this year. All right, everybody, thank you so much. I recorded these, and they're on the module section. If you're late, please stay after. Don't forget those discussions. Keep doing those. We are going to have a little midterm next week, but don't stress about it. All this stuff you hear me say over and over and over again. All right, everybody. Hopefully I won't have these. Well, I'm still going to have my stitches next week. All right, everybody. Have a great weekend. I'll see you guys. All right. Adios.